Guys, so this is another video tutorial. So this time we're going to be working on. I forgot to one sec. I definitely need to fix this real quick. Okay, so this is another video tutorial for 3DS Max. So we are going to work on this right here. So we'll come up here into the left viewport as always. I think this is the 1440, or hold on a minute. I don't remember. This is why I gotta keep looking at this to remember what I'm doing. Nope. This be 1440. 2560. So I think this one is going to be an interesting one. It's not like the other ones we did. This one has this just joint in the center, where the lure actually wobbles from the backside like a tail. So yeah. So I'm thinking that I might start from back here. Then I'm gonna get rid of these segments. As for the height, I think that's too much. Alright, so let's get a look here. We just gotta widen this out some. Like so. And this right here, it'd be widened out a little bit too. Not much, because this is kind of shaped funny. However, we're looking at this at a perspective. So, like this viewport right here, because when we're looking at something at a 3D angle, when you start adding more geometry and stuff, you're always gonna see that part right here. Plus this is angled different too. But it should turn out okay. let's work on the front part first. About right there. This is obvious, like one of those other model that the eye is actually blended into the material, so it's not 3D as well. Now it's going to kind of look a little bit rough from the start. You see these sharp points right here. We'll fix that here soon. Now this one is kind of different. You can see down here that this is towards center. So there is definitely something in the center here. On top of this lib. I have a question for you guys. If you guys are paying attention to this video, what do you call this? Is this a lip or is it called a lib? L-I-B or is it L-I-P? Please tell me in the comments below. Because I had a little bit of discussion with somebody on my Discord, and they told me it's called a lib, but I don't know, to be honest with you. It just sounds weird, because I always knew, from what I known, that it's called a lib, but maybe it's called a lib, I don't know. Alright, so this part right here. Just going to do a copy of it. Do about right there. And then I'm just going to extrude this. So now the next thing to do is to scale this down. I'm just going to have to attach this. Like I said, this model feels different than the rest. I mean, it's kind of like the first model we did, the Whopper Plopper. Now I kind of made a mistake on the model. I should have looked at the design a little bit more. The tail part is completely all in one. So there's not two sections. So it, I don't know how that's gonna work. I mean, it might work. But I wouldn't know. Because we look at 3D models and stuff. They're not the same as, as real life. So, you really would never know how something would work. Okay. All right, so let's get a look at this here. I wish there was a top view of this, but I'm gonna guess that this is. I'm gonna bring up another page here. See if I can find another jointed Shad Rap or something that's similar to it. So yeah, this is where I get all my references from. They got the best view for doing these models because they're presented this in this way, so it's easy to use as a reference image. Here's something similar to what we're looking at. This might show a top view. Or then again, maybe not. There are 33 pages to look around here. But I don't think I'm gonna find anything like it. So, let's see. We're just gonna have to play it by, basically, play it by view. So, we're going to, this way here is kind of too sharp. Excuse me. Like I said, we're going to attach that to that. Okay. All right, let's go into the FD box. We'll go 6x6. Hold on a minute. I don't want attach. The plane, I just want. Just want that right there. Right, so we'll start from this point on right here first. Like I said, we've got to guess how this actually looks. Maybe that's how it looks. I don't know, but looks okay to me so far. Okay, it's bring this into view. Flaps is down. Alright, so the next thing to do, obviously we can't see what this is down here. No top view or nothing, so we'll save this real quick. Now we're going to merge one of these into the scene here. I would try to find that. What would it be? The DT. Excuse me. DT crank. We'll grab one of these. We'll open. And we'll just detach this. Then we'll wait, we wanted to grab the hooks too, I think. I definitely want to grab the hooks off here. Attach that as well. Now we'll close that and get rid of it. Okay, obviously these hooks are way too big. Or is it? Let's see. No, I actually think the hooks are about the right size. Oops. Quick rotate. Now, as for this jointed middle, I think I'm gonna deal with this one right here, or is it this one? Yeah, it's this one right here. For the texturing. Because I'm going to try to do a professional render here. That basically the proper pose of something if it's going to be rendered as a product by itself. I'll name this too. Because I'll show you what I'm talking about. The way I've been rendering lately, it's okay, it works for what I'm doing, but like a product shot, let me bring it up here. It'll be under the reference image here. Basically the render pose. Okay, see how this is actually presented? This is actually basically laying on its side with this back part curved a bit, and you can see the hook is lying right against the basically the bottom or the floor or something like that. Same for here. So this is what we're going to try to mimic. So this is going to be rotated downward. up until we're ready to put this in the proper pose. Now, to actually make this look a little bit better, I'm going to drag this up over here. Okay. Alright, let's work on his lip here. Boy, I'm going to have another discussion with my friend here. Keep calling it lip. Actually, I'm going to close this second. I'm going to put this over here. Open. Then I'm going to drag this across. Delete that. And I'm just going to delete this stuff right down the center. Because obviously there is something here that is different. I also want to rotate this slightly, as it shows it there. Turn that off. Alright, so I'm going to grab a copy of this for now. So I can put another material on here so I can see what I'm doing. So let's grab this plane and this, and we'll isolate it for a minute. So we want to go from here, grab. Always straight to the end. Then I think we're going to extrude this down. Like so. I make sure we grab all this, and this has got to be flat. We'll create a edge loop in here. And then I'm going to save this because I'm just guessing. I think we just weld these. this will go here, and that will go up here. Alright. Alright, so these here is gotta be brought in. Like that. And we're going to take this section here and we're going to connect. Alright, let's add a symmetry modifier to this. Now we add a symmetry modifier to it. Okay. This is not supposed to be cut out. So I'm gonna have to collapse this. I need to connect. I do the same for the other side. Wait, never mind, there's not other side. Maybe I don't need to do that. Let's see what this looks like. Alright, let's unhide the rest and we'll take this and bring this back into the center here. This goes back to wireframe for a minute. Put that bolt right there. Way off of the center here. I'm going to actually shrink this down some. I'm gonna delete those. Sync this a little bit more. About right there. Yeah, she's sleeping.
What's her oxygen right when she's sleeping?
I have no idea. So you try to put the damn thing on, she wakes up. Yeah. I don't want to make a copy of the pivot, then it won't work. Copy of this. Then I'll make one more copy. Then I'll attach. There, I gotta center this. I'm gonna rotate this. Try to lay it so it actually looks natural. Okay, so that's all done. Now we just gotta texture it. So we gotta do something here first. Otherwise, this is gonna peer into the texture. I don't want that. So we're gonna grab this. Let me just grab from here. I'm just gonna drag down a little bit. Try and get rid of anything that might repeat. I don't know if I can get rid of this or not. I'm gonna try. No. Alright, I'll just keep it then. Oh yeah, we're not done. Hold on a minute. We gotta fix this right here. We gotta cap this. Or no, not yet. We'll create ourselves. Then we'll cap it. We gotta create a nice sharp edge right here. We gotta do the same for this side. Oh, hold on a second. I'm actually going to pull this up for a second, but I can actually put it back though. Alright, now I can put it back. Alright, this here also need to have it inset, and this edge to be done the same. I'm gonna do these couple that won't work. There should do. Okay, now to create that joint here in the center. Pretty simple, we'll just open this. We'll detach. Then we'll do a rotate. Like that. We'll just drag this like this. Alright, now we got it jointed now. Now we're going after once we get this material added to this, then we're gonna have to detach this and only attach it to this as a separate section. This will be the back, that'll be the front. Okay, so let's get it set to apply the textures to this. All right, I'm gonna merge the lights in here. right here. Alright, now we can try to texture this. So, we'll hide the plane. And this grid. So we're gonna come up here to symmetry. And simple, we'll just come here, just grab one section, delete, grab another section, and delete. Deleted. Actually, I'm not gonna delete that yet. I forgot to do something. This front area right here needs something done to it still. Otherwise, it's gonna be too flat. So, inset this. Right there. We'll chamfer this. There. Alright, now we can delete. Actually, this is going to be 02, I think. Or, hold on a second. Let me close that off. I'm going to name this 3. So I can name this 1. Then this will be named 2. That way there's no confusion. Now, obvious, I want to detach this now. this section right here to be the front. Alright, so we'll come up here to the UV unwrap. Select all. Right now I'm working on this part accordingly. Move this over here. All right. Now, collapse this. Now I gotta do the same for this side. That should do it. I could put that on now. I do one other thing here. I didn't do it on the last one, I should have. So from here, There's actually a little tiny something going all the way back from there. About right there. Then we want to make it visible in the render. Okay, so we gotta do this real quick. Otherwise, when you go to render, it's not gonna show right. Okay, we gotta symmetry these. Collapse. All right, so let's do a quick save here. Now for his backside, we need to attach that to this side. So we're gonna grab this and we'll put this at 14. Same thing with this and that one. Right, so now we'll come up here to attach. We'll want to match this one. We gotta attach these all. Gotta get rid of that. There. All right, now on this side, I'm gonna have to attach those hooks to that. So now I'll come up here, grab the pivot. I want to actually put this right in the center, about right there. So now, when we actually rotate this, this will actually move like it should. Alright, so let's we're gonna hide these lights real quick. And we're going to group this whole entire thing. Alright, so let's bring up the image so we can get this posed right. Might want to change this color of this. Something that's actually noticeable, maybe yellow. There you go. So we kind of want to. Let me save that. So we kind of want to rotate this down, like so. And we want to do this first. That center I had in the first place. Okay, now we'll close this. Wrong way. Now we gotta do these hooks now. I feel like that somehow this is not render it looking right. The pose isn't the same. How is this stand? Obviously, this hook right here. Kind of straightens out like that. And I think this going with the same here. I'm gonna have to detach that hook for a minute. This is why I created a separate save. This also gotta be detached. How is this standing is the question. I don't know how this thing is propped up, cause I this is it seems impossible. Because gravity isn't pulling right. This should be like this. Because it'd still be at an angle. Then the hooks. This whole thing's gonna have to be lifted. That could be like that because this is jointed, so that would make sense. This be the only way that this would actually make sense of how this would be on its side, because it'll be leaning against this lip thing right here, and the hooks would be laying flat. This hook right here would be laying flat, and this would be at an angle because, well, the way it'd be laying. Alright, let's do a render here. I think this will work out. Oh, actually, wait one sec. I want to close this whole thing. I just want to rotate this to this way. Because on this side is where the best light is going to be. Anyway, this is kind of how you want it to look. The way it's laying. That's how it actually you would think it would be laying if it was just on its surface. But anyways, I am going to undo the changes. That way above here. Okay, something is kind of a little bit concerning me a bit. This right here needs to be done some with, because otherwise we're gonna have a wide issue here. What we could do is come up here. UV unwrap. Actually, shrink this down some. That's how I like about right here. we gotta do the same for this side. See how that's looking? We don't want that stretching. The people that you want to sell to would not like it. Did I forget to do a thigh here? I thought I'd chamfer this. Here, same thing. UV on wrap. Looks better. Alright, so let's actually do it the real render now. Yeah, trying to pose this in a way that actually makes sense can be tricky. Anyways, this concludes the tutorial. If you guys liked the video, please hit the like button. You guys want you guys to subscribe as well. Appreciate the support, and I thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you in the next tutorial. Until then, bye.